Hey everybody, in this tutorial we're going to talk about creating clothing for your character creator character from an OBJ file. In this case we're going to be downloading one from Sketchfab. And right now you can see the host character that we're going to be transferring the clothing onto in just a moment. But first of all, let's go over to Sketchfab and take a look at the items that we're going to be bringing over here. So in Sketchfab you can see we have this basic simple t-shirt. Let's give it a little rotate there. You can see what we're dealing with here. I'm going to transfer this t-shirt onto our character by importing an OBJ file into Character Creator. Okay, this is on our Reillusion Sketchfab channel here. So I'm going to go ahead and down here, just go ahead and download it. You can select download, and luckily I've already downloaded it for us, so I can just go ahead and close this window down and find that download folder right here. And it'll download as this kind of like a zip file right here. And once you unzip that, you'll have this folder right here with an OBJ file of our t-shirt, t-pose, along with some specular, normal, and diffuse maps right there. Okay, so let's go ahead and go into Character Creator and set about importing that t-shirt in. So I'm going to go here to File and Clothing, Hair, and Accessories. All right, and we're going to import that t-shirt in. Let's go ahead and select the t-shirt right here, the OBJ file. And once we've imported that in, notice that it'll import in as an accessory first, and I'll talk about that in just a moment. But the first item of business here is we want to get the transform position correct. We want to get the position on the character correct. Now you may have to scale this in some cases as well, so let's go ahead down here and just go, first of all, I want to make sure that my pivot point for my t-shirt is in the right place. Currently it's down here at our character base. If I press the W hotkey, you can see it's down there. That's not really useful if we're trying to get the positioning correct. So let's change our pivot position to the middle, right there. All right, there we go. And we'll just bring it down a little bit, just like this, on the Z-axis, and bring it a little bit forward there. And we should be good to go. I think that looks fine and dandy. Okay, one other thing to note as well is if you notice that, take a look at the character's neck, you'll see that the material is not two-sided. So if you want to make sure it's two-sided, you can go over here to Materials, and there's a little two-sided clicker parameter down here. Just make sure that box is selected, and boom, you have a two-sided mesh there. Okay, so the first item of business here is we want to make sure that we transfer the skin weights from the shirt to our character's bones there. Okay, so to give an example of why that's necessary, let's go ahead and choose a different pose for our character. So under poses, I'm going to go to body and just choose a motion. Let's choose a female pose, maybe this jump pose right here. And she'll jump right out of her t-shirt. Okay, obviously that's not what we want. So we need to make sure that we transfer those skin weights. So let's bring her back into the original T-pose we had her in there. Going into motions here and the T-pose. All right, and we need to go ahead and make sure the T-shirt is selected. Go to our attributes up here, and at the very top, there is a section for transfer skin weights under modify. That's transfer skin weights option there. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and select that. We're going to use the default template for now. This is just the first and simplest example. We're going to talk more about the other stuff a little bit later on. So just choose default and go ahead and apply that. And once that's done applying, we've automatically transferred the skin weights to our character. We can close down this panel and just choose a different pose again. Let's choose jump. Yay! I like this jump pose. Okay, so you can see all the weights have been transferred to our character correctly. You can see the bra might be poking through there in the back. We can just go ahead and actually delete that bra. I can just go to the scene manager and select it. Since we don't need it anyways, we'll just go ahead and delete it. It's getting in the way. All right, so we'll just go ahead and keep that right there. We'll change it back into a T-pose. Let's just go back to the motion root folder here and back into T-pose. And let's bring in our second item. But before we do that, if you wanted to, like, you know, say, for example, smooth out the character's mesh, let's just change our character's t-shirt color temporarily here. And I'm just going to go down to diffuse color here for our materials. We'll just change it to a nice healthy gray there. I'm not sure why it said healthy. But let's go to the attributes there, and we're going to go ahead and try and smooth the mesh a little bit. So we'll go to Edit Mesh, and you have the option here to Sculpt. And in Sculpt, you can choose the Smooth option, and we can just change the strength to, like, you know, 0.05. That's fine. And then we can, you know, smooth out the mesh like this if we want. In some cases, you don't want to go too much, because if I go like too much, you can see that we have some of our characters' breasts poking through. I'll just Control Z and undo that. But just wanted to show you here that you have the option to smooth out the mesh as well in a lot of cases. Okay, in any case, really, the amount of smoothing really depends on yourself, how much smoothing you want to do. Okay, but we have that option. Okay, so let's go ahead and get out of here. We'll just get out of edit mesh by clicking on it again. Let's change our character's diffuse color back to the original white color there. All right. And let's go ahead and take a look at importing in the gene shorts. Those are going to be a little bit more complicated. So let's go ahead and focus on our character's midsection here, the hips, and we're going to go ahead to the same process, create cloth hair accessory, and import in this time the gene shorts. Okay, pants modifier, they're called, the OBJ file. All right, so once those are imported in, we go through the same process. Let's change our pivot point again to go to attributes to the bottom, change it to the middle there. And make sure the W key is pressed so we can have our transform gizmo and just move those pants right into place. And we'll probably want to make the t-shirt invisible at this point. So let's go up here to our scene manager and just click on the little eye icon there beside the t-shirt, make it invisible. Select our pants. I think we're okay. We can probably press the W hotkey, bring them a little bit forward just to get rid of that breakage to the front mesh there. That should be okay. All right, we're good. If you want to scale them, you can do so as well. Just press the R hotkey. You scale them a little bit more on the green Y-axis there. That should be fine. And again, they can be double-sided as well, or two-sided. Just go to the materials, and down here to two-sided. Shabam, there we go. Okay, a little bit loose around our hips, but we can talk about that in another tutorial. Okay, so right now we have these jean shorts. Same process again. Go over here to attributes and transfer skin weights. And this time we're going to go ahead and select the default mode again and go ahead and apply it. We'll talk about lateral partitioning in just a moment. Okay, so once we've done that, let's go ahead and take a look at a couple different poses. Let's make our character shirt visible again, just temporarily. Let's go to the content tab here and female pose. Let's give her like another jump pose. Okay, looks fine. Okay, but we need to go down here to maybe something like stand 01. And it stands there. Well, let's take a closer look down here. You can see that we have, you know, one side of the jean shorts is the skin weights are transferred to the wrong bone, the wrong leg. Okay, so in order to fix that, let's take our character back into the T-pose. Motion tab there. Motion folder there. And we need to make sure that we select lateral partitioning. All right, lateral partitioning for our shorts. Make sure the shorts are selected. Yep. And make sure that we have that selected there. There we go. Okay, so we need to reselect it. And you'll notice that this section here is sort of purple, and that's what's causing the problem there. So the automatic skinning, skin transfer, basically assigned this little section here to the wrong leg bone. Okay? But luckily that's easily fixed. All we need to do is just go ahead and click and drag in this section here. Make sure not to select any of the character's right leg. We're only selecting the left leg, okay? So all these red points here have been selected. And make sure we assign that to the left partition, okay? The character's left leg, all right? There we go. And also you want to make sure, I forgot to mention, that you deselect ignore back faces because it might be going all the way through as well. I'll just redo that one more time very quickly there. And left, okay. And the same thing we do on the other side. Click on this section here and select the right partition, okay? And then when we apply that, we're going to be able to fix that problem. Let's go and test out that same motion, content, female pose, and stand 01. Okay, there you go. All fixed. However, you'll notice that if we look, take a little bit of a closer look, that there's some stretching of the mesh. So the skin transfer, the weight transfer rather, was not ideal. The automatic transfer was not ideal, so we can manually fix that. Let's get into a different pose just temporarily here. I'm going to go to the motion tab and go to the male pose. I'm going to choose a very extreme pose, which is this one, stand against the wall here. You can see his legs are very spread out. And there you go, just like that. Let's just make the t-shirt invisible right now. Scene manager there. And we're going to focus on this section here. Let's also delete the underwear bottoms. We don't need those. So we can delete those. Okay, so obviously there's an issue here where the skin weight is not ideal. So in order to fix that, we need to adjust that manually. So let's select our pants and go over here to skin weights. Okay, not transfer skin weights, manual skin weights. All right, so now we get to do some manual editing. And you can see, some problems with the skin weights kind of stretching to one another there. So what you want to do is in order to, let's go first and select smooth here, the smooth brush. I'm going to change my strength to like 0.05, lower level there. the radius of our brush is okay. We can adjust that if we want. But what you want to do first is you want to right-click on the bone that you want to assign the weighting to. Okay, so for example, I'm going to right-click on her left leg there, and you can see that we have this kind of spectrum of colors kind of fading from blue to orange, and we need to make sure that we weight this properly. So I'm going to go ahead and click and drag to, you know, brush our smooth our leg out there. And we're just going to do something like this, you know, make sure it's nice and smoothed out. And then you can go ahead and right click on her right leg, just like this, right click there, and do the same thing on this side. Okay, and this should help to smooth things out. Okay, just kind of bring it up like that and somewhere like that. And then you can right click on the hip bone, which is the middle one, and you can kind of just smooth it even further, just like this. Okay, now this, you know, may take a few minutes. It's hard to get an ideal shape right off the bat. You kind of need to go back and forth and do a lot of this stuff back and forth here. Let's go ahead and just kind of maybe work with that. I think that'll look okay in the end. Let's just control the last one there. And if you think you've got everything cool, just go ahead and click skin weights again. And you can see it's okay. At least there's no stretching of the mesh. Now, this is an extreme example where our characters, you know, the texture is really stretching out. But if we want to go ahead and maybe select a different pose, like a content, and let's go back to our female poses here, and something like the Stanzer one, the one we originally had, you can see that it'll look fine and dandy, okay? So generally, this is the kind of pose that you're going to work with. Maybe we can try the jump again. I really like that jump. And there you go. The mesh is kind of breaking through there, but you get the point. If your character's legs are kind of open, like in these kind of poses like that, then that issue is mostly fixed for the most part, the skin weighting. Okay, let's run the collision now for our t-shirt and our jean shorts. So I'm going to go to the scene manager here and make our t-shirt visible one more time. Now let's just choose a different, like the Stanzer 1 pose right here. Or let's choose the T pose for now, actually, just to get things back to basics. There we go. So what I want to do is, with my t-shirt selected, make sure we go up here to conform, okay? And we have the option to calculate collision. So I'm going to go ahead and just calculate collision for my shirt. And it should, you know, generally kind of calculate the collision over top of the jeans there. You can kind of increase the size slightly, maybe to like something like this, and try to recalculate the collision there. And you should get, you know, generally what you want, the t-shirt kind of layering over top of those jeans. What you also want to do is make sure you go down here to cloth layer settings, okay? And you can see here we have the t-shirt on layer 4 and the pants on layer 1. So the pants are the first layer closest to the skin, and the t-shirt is the fourth layer. You can just go ahead and run collision again if you want. There you go, and that should basically fix the entire issue right there. So you can run the collision separately or run them all together. All right, so finally let's take a look at importing in the shoes, which are basically the same process. So again, let's go up to Create here, Cloth Hair Accessories. And this time we're going to select the OBJ for the shoes and import those in. And you can see the shoes are a little bit misplaced as well. There's a little bit of issue there. So let's press the W hotkey to move the position of the shoes. Make sure they're kind of where they should be. All right. And let's take a look as well. We can see on the right hand or on the left shoe here, there's some breakage through on the mesh as well as on the right shoe. Now, if we move them together, there's going to be a problem. There's going to be too much breakage on one side and too little breakage on the other side. So what we're going to do is we're going to edit the mesh by individual elements. So let's go up here to Edit Mesh. And instead this time of choosing the vertex and face, we're going to choose Edit by Element. Okay, and when you select by element, there's two separate shoes, which are two separate elements of the mesh. Okay, so I'm going to just double-click on the left shoe, and that'll highlight in red, and I can press the W hotkey and move this shoe individually now. Okay, let's move it just enough to kind of cover up that breakage. And maybe center it on the ankle there. There we go, that should be okay. Make sure there's no breakage on the inside. All right, we're good to go. Let's do the same thing for the right shoe. Just double click on the right shoe there, and we'll kind of move this over a little bit as well, just to avoid that breakage. And we want to place it kind of centered on the ankle there as well. Something like this would be okay. Make sure there's no breakage on the inside there as well. All right, and I think we're good to go. Of course, you can use the E hotkey as well to rotate if you need, but we're just going to worry about the transform right now. Okay, so I'm going to deselect Edit Mesh. And once we're done that, the next item of business, obviously, is to transfer the skin weights. So let's go ahead and transfer skin weights for the shoes. And this time we're not going to use the default template. We're going to use the shoe template, okay? Because there's a special template just for shoes. All right, so we'll go ahead and select that and apply. And within a second there, those shoes should be skinned quite nicely to our character's ankles, or to her feet rather, okay? And ankles. All right, so let's go ahead and test it out with a couple poses. Let's go over here to female pose and try something where, like, maybe something like this, where she's kind of standing in a weird position. All right, looks like they are okay. Skinned nicely to our character's ankles and feet. Try another one here, maybe like this one. And you can see there we have those shoes skinned nicely to our character's feet. All right, we're good to go. Now you want to make sure as well that you have the correct the shoes and every item on your character on the correct layer to avoid having them conflict. I mean, in this case, it doesn't really matter. There's only three simple items. But if you want, you can go up to conform here. And with conform selected, we'll go down to the very bottom and choose cloth layer settings. And you can just make this window larger or smaller by clicking on the window like that. And you can see that the shoes are on the top layer and the t-shirt is on the second layer and below that is the pants. Okay. And you can adjust the layer position right here, collision order if you want, just like this. Now, as a reference for this, if you go to our wiki, you'll find on the wiki here, there's a little graph on this page, import process. There's a little graph that shows all the different items and which layer they should be on. Let's go ahead and back into Character Creator. So shoes can be on layer 5. If you want, it doesn't really matter in this case since there's only three simple items. You can change the collision order right here. The t-shirt, we can change the collision order for the t-shirt. A lot more options there. But I think we're pretty much good right here. Again, once you get more complicated stuff like boots and shoes and socks and all that stuff, then you'll need to worry about this a little bit more. And that guide can be found again right here on that wiki. And again, if you come across any more issues, you can always run collision or calculate collision here for individual items on your character. So now if we want to save our objects, we need to go into the custom tab with our t-shirt selected. Let's go over here to clothing. And I'm going to make sure I right-click and create a new folder here in my custom tab. We'll call this Sketch Fab, okay? And we'll go into Sketch Fab, this folder right here. And you can just go ahead and make sure it's conformed. Make sure that the cloth name is right there. Just right-click or click on the plus button down there, and your shirt item should appear in the Content Manager in just a moment. There we go. We'll just call it T-shirt. Okay. There we go. And let's go ahead and do the rest. Let's do the jean shorts there as well. So jean shorts, we're going to press plus. And we'll call those pants. Okay. Not really pants, but we'll call them pants for now. And the same thing for the shoes. So select the shoes, press plus. And again, you can put these all in the same folder. It doesn't really matter which folder structure you use. It can be totally customized to your own liking. Just make sure that everything's on the right layer. Okay. And there you go. Here's our original saving right there, with the nicer looking thumbnails. And here you can see the source. So this is the t-shirt that we brought in for our default character. And if you apply this this set of clothing to any characters, you can morph your character's shape. You can apply it to, now that you've saved it as a character creator clothing item, you can basically apply it to any character you want. It'll conform to their body shape. Really cool stuff. So that's about it for this tutorial, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully you learned a lot. Make sure you check out our forums at forum.reillusion.com. And I hope to see you in the next video.